The Bible reads, then came to him the disciples of John, saying, why do we and the Pharisees fast oft, but thy disciples fast not? Amen. Does your Bible say that? Amen. Mine does too. Amen. It's a powerful word of prayer. Come down, Holy Spirit. Help us to exalt Jesus. Come down, Holy Spirit, and bless your people, Father. Those that need comforting, Lord, we pray that you will comfort them, Lord. And those that need healings, Lord, and healings in their bodies, we speak your word this morning that by your stripes we heal. And the prayer of faith shall save the sick, Lord. Touch everybody this morning, Lord. Hear the prayers going forward about families this morning, Lord. Bless the families, Lord, with unity and one accord and love and peace, Lord. And let your angels watch over the family, Lord. And that, Lord, as stated already, help our young people, Lord. We bind that suicide spirit, Lord. Bind all that evil activity, Lord God. Turn our youth around, Father. Give them joy, Lord, and unspeakable joy, Lord. Special prayers are going up this morning, Lord. Those in the hospital, Lord, and those in convalescent homes, Lord. Those in ICUs, Lord. Those going through surgeries, Lord. Doctor's appointments, Lord. We speak in your word, Lord. And by your stripes we heal, Lord. And we pray for deliverance, Lord. For those on alcoholism and drug addiction, Lord. And turn them around, Father. Those in homosexuality, Lord. Those who are backsliding, Lord. Living in the world, Lord. Deliver right now, Father. Those special heart requests, those unspoken requests this morning, Lord. Hear their prayers. Hear our prayers this morning, Lord. And we believe you, Lord God, for double blessings, Lord. For everybody, Lord. Abundance, Lord. For everybody, Lord. Restoration, Lord. For everybody, Lord. Somebody need a miracle this morning, Lord. For miracles, Lord. Never a lack, Father. Respect, Lord. And especially young people, Lord, they might know who they are, Lord. Chosen generation, royal priesthood. And we bind that devil, Lord. Bind the enemy, Lord. And we thank you for your divine presence, Lord. And we're going to give you a shout of praise because we believe all these things and more are going to happen on this morning. In Jesus' holy name we pray. We say amen, amen, amen. Give God a shout of praise this morning. Bless your word. Save souls. Save lives. Amen. We give honor to God who sent his son, Jesus Christ, to die on the cross of Calvary for all of our sins. And we thank God for the testimony that he hung, he bled, he died, but on the third day, he got up from the grave. Tell about three neighbors, that's good news. Amen. And ushers, I want to use as a subject title this morning, at the party, amen. Would you tell three neighbors, at the party, amen. Amen. All right, at the party, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Somebody said, take me back, amen. But not too far back, amen. If you remember, from a couple of weeks ago, we said Matthew, the tax collector, threw a party for Jesus. And he invited all his friends, which were other tax collectors. And besides him, the others were just called sinners. Amen. Hallelujah. And at the party, the Pharisees started criticizing Jesus. Talk about he's socializing with publicans and sinners. Tax collectors and sinners. Where other folks were called the riffraff of life. Some would even just call them the low-down folks, amen. They were the hated folks. Today, but Jesus socialized with them, amen. Hallelujah. If you look at me at Matthew chapter 9 and verse number 11 in recollection, the Bible says, and when the Pharisees saw it, they said unto his disciples, why eateth your master with publicans and sinners? Does your Bible say that? But Jesus has an answer for them. As a matter of fact, Jesus has an answer for every situation, for all our circumstances, because Jesus is the answer, amen. Tell about three neighbors, Jesus is the answer, amen. If you look at Matthew chapter 9 and verse number 12, the Bible says, but when Jesus heard that, he said unto them, they that be whole need not a physician, but they that are sick. As a physician, Jesus came to heal the sin sick soul. How many know that there's some sick folks out there? How many know there's some sick folks in here? Amen. Don't have to go far, amen. And no harm, no shame to be about it, amen. You have to be careful when you're at the party, amen, Terry. Because strange things can happen at the party. As a matter of fact, unexpected things can happen at the party. Can I back it up? If you look with me at Matthew chapter 9 and verse number 14, the Bible says, then came to him the disciples of John, saying, why do we and the Pharisees fast off, but thy disciples fast not? Does your Bible say that? Young people, let me tell you this, that stuff can happen at the party. People who you think are your homies, I mean disciples, I mean your friends, amen, can change on you at the party. I should say what's really in their hearts can come out at the party. Would y'all help me this morning? Emotions can come out at the party. Can I break that down? Jealousies can come out at the party. These disciples who were criticizing Jesus join forces with the Pharisees, with the enemy, and they were supposed to be the disciples of John the Baptist, but there were some jealousies on the inside of them because Jesus is becoming a little bit too popular. Tell us about three neighbors, stuff can come out at the party, amen. I know you all have never partied before, so I'm helping you out, amen. Can I back it up this morning? If you look at John chapter 3 and verse 26 in the NIV, just look up here, amen. The Bible says, they came to John and said to him, Rabbi, that man who was with you on the other side of the Jordan, and they're talking about Jesus, the one you testified about, well, he is baptizing and everyone is going to him. Tell three neighbors at the party. Mm-hmm. This was supposed to be a party of a lot of riffraffs getting together, publican and sinners, low-down hated folks, but those folks weren't giving Jesus any trouble. It was the people who were supposed to know God, help me, Holy Ghost, they were giving him all the trouble. Help me, Holy Ghost. Sometimes, but I won't go there, amen. John never claimed to be the Christ. John the Baptist never claimed to be the Son of God. Matter of fact, John the Baptist said, Jesus is the bridegroom. I'm just a friend of the bridegroom. Hallelujah. He says, I'm not the one. He's the one. Can I back it up this morning? If you go to John chapter 3 and verses 29 to 30, amen. The Bible says, he that hath the bride is the bridegroom. This is John talking. But the friend of the bridegroom, which standeth and heareth him, rejoices greatly because of the bridegroom's voice. This my joy therefore is fulfilled. But here's what I'm looking for. And this is what John had to say about the whole matter. He must increase. I need some help this morning. John knew who he was. He said, he must increase, but I must decrease. Tell about three neighbors, he must increase, but I must decrease. Am I right about it? Now watch this now. Little by little, Matthew is letting us know a little bit more about who this Jesus is. They're finding out who he is. John the Baptist called him the bridegroom. Somebody say bridegroom. And Jesus refers to himself as the bridegroom. Can I back it up? If you look at Matthew chapter 9 and verse number 15, the Bible says, and Jesus said unto them, can the children of the bride chamber mourn as long as the what? The bridegroom is with them. Watch it now. But the days will come when the what? When the bridegroom shall be taken from them, and then what shall they fast? Can y'all run with me now? What is the big deal about Jesus being the bridegroom? Well, God, Yahweh, is the bridegroom in the Old Testament to Israel. This is another way of saying, if you're saying I'm the bridegroom, you say I am God. Hallelujah. God is referred to as the bridegroom in the Old Testament. The bridegroom is Yahweh in the Old Testament. It's God in the Old Testament. He's married to Israel. Can I back it up this morning? Hosea chapter 2 and verses 19 and 20. The Bible says, and I will betroth thee unto me, how long? Forever. Yea, I will betroth thee unto me in righteousness. Hallelujah. and in judgment, and in loving kindness, and in mercies. Does your Bible say that? I will even betroth thee unto me in faithfulness, and thou shalt know the Lord. Tell about three neighbors, it's good to know the Lord. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, he is the bridegroom. Hallelujah. Not only that, he is the physician. He's the chief physician. The physician heals the sick. But this morning, I want to talk about the bridegroom. The bridegroom brings spiritual joy. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, this joy I have, the world didn't give it to me. Oh, the world can't take it away. Take it every neighbor. I got it from the bridegroom. Hallelujah. Jesus is saying, I am the bridegroom, and I'm here now in the flesh. So this is a time of celebration, because I bring spiritual joy. When I'm here, it's a wedding feast. It's a festival. It's a celebration. It's joy. It's unspeakable joy. Well, a Jewish wedding was a time of special festivity. For a week long after the wedding, the couple had an open house where everybody could come in, and the bride and the bridegroom were treated as king and queen. They were even addressed as the king and the queen. Let me break it down. At the party, they had the King of Kings with them. Help me, Holy Ghost. Already with them. So there was no need to be fasting then. They had the bridegroom in the flesh already with them. So they didn't need to fast right then and there. What they needed, all they needed, whatever they could need, they had right there. They had Jesus in the flesh. When you have Jesus in your presence in the flesh, it's a time of celebration. Would you tell your neighbor, neighbor, that's a true party. When you have Jesus in your midst, in the flesh, you have joy, spiritual joy. They had Christ, the Son of God, the Messiah, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. It wasn't a time to fast. It was a time to rejoice. To your neighbor, neighbor, it's time to rejoice. Hallelujah. But then he tells them that there was going to come a time when they should fast, when Jesus would be taken away from them. Can I back it up? Let's look in that verse 15 again, Matthew chapter 9 and verse 15, that lower part. And Jesus said unto them, can the children of the bride chamber mourn as long as the bridegroom is with them? Watch it now. But the days will come. Somebody said, we'll come. Somebody said, we'll come. He's letting them know, but the days will come when the bridegroom, can y'all hear me, shall be taken away from them. Watch it now. And then shall they what?
Fast.
Then shall they fast. Help me, Holy Ghost. He said the day will come when the bridegroom will be taken away. This is the first recorded instance of Jesus referring to his death in the Gospel of Matthew. He's saying, one day I'm going to be taken away from you. Then you should fast. I won't be with you always physically. One day I'm going to be taken away. And your natural circumstances, your natural situations, help me, Holy Ghost, is going to make you fast then. The early disciples of Jesus, after he was taken away, then they began to fast. Can I back it up? Acts chapter 13 and verse number 2, hallelujah. The Bible says, as they ministered to the Lord, and what? I can't hear you. And fasted. The Holy Ghost said, separate me, Barnabas and Saul, for the work whereunto I have called them. When you fast, the Holy Ghost will start talking. He'll speak to you. He'll give you directions. He'll give you guidance. If you don't know what to do, or how to do it, or what to say, if you fast and pray, God will put the words in your mouth. Can I back it up this morning? Tell your neighbor, it's time to fast and pray. Can I back it up? Acts chapter 14, hallelujah, verses 22 and 23. The Bible says, confirming the souls of the disciples and exhorting, which means encouraging them to continue in the faith. Somebody said, continue in the faith. And that we, look at there, must through much tribulation enter into the kingdom of God. And when they had ordained them elders in every church and had prayed with what? With fasting, they commended them to the Lord, on whom they believe. Well, if you're going through trials and tribulation and trouble and heartaches and pain, I got a recommendation for you this morning. Try fasting and praying, and God will see you through. Tell your neighbor, turn your plate down, and God will see you through. If you need help, if we need help, if we need guidance, if we need power, if we need strength, if we need healing, if we need joy, if we need encouragement, if we need forgiveness, if we need comfort, if we need hope, if we need healing, if we need wisdom, if we need counsel, if we need blessing, if we need financing, whatever we need, just try fasting and praying. Take your neighbor, there's power in fasting and praying. Can I back it up? Paul said he had to fast and pray his way through trials and dangers and heavy burdens. Can I back it up this morning? 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 27 and 8. Amen. Praise God. 2 Corinthians, hallelujah. That's it. Hey, that's correct. Amen. That's 2 Corinthians. The Bible says, and Paul was going through this, he said, in weariness. Yeah, he's testifying. Some of y'all got this testimony. And painfulness. Can I get a witness? In watching often. Come on now. In hunger. He had to go through some stuff. And thirst. In fasting a little bit. In fasting often. In cold. And what? Nakedness. Watch it now. Besides, those things are without. Help me, Holy Ghost. That which cometh upon me, how often?
Daily.
Daily. The care of all the churches. And y'all thought you had problems. He had problems too. Well, in the Old Testament, you heard in Sunday school, there was a man named Daniel. He fasted and he prayed until God came through and broke through and sent an angel through to give him information about his life and about his nation. But he had to fast and pray to get the breakthrough. To your neighbor, neighbor, oh neighbor, you might have to fast and pray until you get your breakthrough. One time he fasted 21 days. He said the demons held up the angel, but he stayed on his face, fasting and praying until he got his breakthrough. Can I detour for a minute? We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principality, power, rulers of darkness, spiritual wickedness in high places. But keep on fasting and praying till you get your breakthrough. Can I back it up? Daniel chapter 9, verse number 3. The Bible says, and I set my face unto the Lord God to seek by prayer and supplication. With what? Come on, with what? Fasting and sackcloth and ashes. Which means he was mourning over his sin and the sins of the nation. You heard it in Sunday school. Well, Daniel chapter 10, verse 2 and 3. This man was a prayer warrior. It's an honor to be a prayer warrior. The Bible says, in those days, I, Daniel, was mourning 3 full weeks. I ate no pleasant bread. Neither came flesh nor wine in my mouth. He fasted 3 weeks. And I just asked y'all one day, and y'all look cross-eyed at me. I'm just messing with you, amen. Well, in those days, I, Daniel, was mourning 3 full weeks. Which means 21 days, I ate no desirable bread, no pleasant bread, neither came flesh nor wine in my mouth, neither did I anoint myself at all till 3 whole weeks were fulfilled. Well, God heard him, and God answered his prayer. I just got one more before I take my seat. When the odds were against Jehoshaphat, insurmountable odds. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, when things look impossible, when the enemy looked like he had him outnumbered, He called a collective fast.
Yes.
He called a cooperative fast.
Yes.
It's something about when two or more
yes.
get together
yes.
and they agree
yes.
in one accord.
Yes.
That's when you have a true party.
Yes.
Jesus will show up
yes.
and show out.
Yes.
When you got two folks
yes.
on one accord.
Yes.
Two folks
yeah.
talking the same thing,
yeah.
agreeing the same thing.
Yeah.
Two folks walking together,
yeah.
talking together,
yeah.
believing together.
Yeah.
Then three will be there.
Yeah.
Jesus will show up
yeah.
in the midst.
Yeah.
What it looked like Jehoshaphat
yeah.
was defeated.
Yeah.
There was a multitude of army
yeah.
that outnumbered him. Can I back it up?
Yeah.
Second Chronicles
yeah.
chapter 20, 2 and 3. The Bible says, then there came some that told Jehoshaphat, saying, there cometh a great multitude. Not a small one, but a great multitude against thee. From beyond the sea on this side of Syria.
Yes.
And behold,
yes.
they be Hazazon Tamar, which is in Gadai. And Jehoshaphat feared. He was scared. But he knew what to do when you're scared.
Yes.
And set himself to seek the Lord.
Yes.
Am I right about it? And proclaim a fast. And he said, I ain't gonna do it alone. We gonna get in this together.
Yeah.
Tell your neighbor, neighbor,
neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Oh neighbor,
together we can.
Yeah, we can.
And proclaim a fast throughout all Judah.
Yeah.
So everybody got together on one accord.
Yeah.
Together on one accord. Well, Jehoshaphat fasted with everybody else. And then the Lord had a word for him. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, the Lord got a word for you. In 2018, I got a word for you this morning. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, this word is just for you. We look at this camera. This word is just for you. Can I back it up? This is your word for this morning. Second Chronicles chapter 20 verse 15. The Bible says, and he said, hearken, you've been fasting. Ye all Judah, because everybody been fasting. And ye inhabitants of Jerusalem, and thou, King Jehoshaphat, thus saith the Lord unto you. Here's your word for you. Be not afraid nor dismayed by the reason of this great multitude, by what you see, what you hear. Don't be scared. What you're going through,
yeah.
don't be worried
yeah.
about the doctor's report.
Yeah.
Don't be worried about what the judge said.
Yeah.
Don't be worried how the children are acting.
Yeah.
Don't be worried about how you're feeling.
Yeah.
I got a word for you
yeah.
for the battle. I got a word for the battle. I can't hear you for the battle. I need a witness this morning for the battle. If you're going through, if you're hurting this morning, if you're suffering this morning, I got news for you. The battle is not yours. Help me, Holy Ghost. But God, can I talk with you this morning? It's not your fight. It's God's fight. The battle is not yours, but it's God. We got to believe God for double blessing. Somebody said double blessing. The battle is not yours, but the Lord. Somebody said abundance. The battle is not yours, but the Lord. Somebody said restoration. The battle is not yours, but the Lord. Somebody said miracles. The battle is not yours, but the Lord. Somebody said never a lack. The battle is not yours, but the Lord. Somebody said respect. The battle, the battle, the battle, the battle is not yours. I got one more. Divine presence. Wherever I go, he's with me. If you're in the pit, he's with you. If you're in prison, he's with you. If you're in the palace, he's with you. How do I know? The battle. I need a witness this morning. The battle. The battle. The battle. The battle. I got to get some help right here. Let me try this. I need to shout the battle. The battle. Pretty good. Right here. The battle. Almost as good. Amen. One more. I do right here. The battle. First one, y'all doing pretty well. Amen. Right here, the battle. Like might be a tie right here. Amen. Ooh. Ooh. We won already. The battle. Y'all need to come on out here. Amen. On count to three, we're gonna shout. Just get in your spirit. 2018. Fighting many battles. I wish I had a handkerchief. I wish I had a handkerchief. You can throw it up here. I got hands, amen. I caught that, amen. Goliath. Goliath. David. Wasn't scared at all. Because he knew the battle. Fighting that giant. Fighting that giant. 9 feet, 9 inches tall. I just need some rocks. I just need some rocks. 9 feet, 9 inches tall. He's so big I can't miss him. I gotta give me 5 stones. 5 stones. But I only need one. I only need one. I only need one. What you do with the other four? He got 4 sons. If they want some of this, they can come on too. 1 stone for each one. Cause the battle. I need some help. Help the church. The battle. Oh, I got some help, Jesus. The battle. Children not acting right. Husband not acting right. Doctor gave you a bad report. Don't feel good. Don't look good. Hard circumstances. Hard situations. Going through this. Going through that. Putting up with this. Putting up with that. Get my 5 rocks. This wrestle's going down. Cause the battle. Come on. The battle is not yours. But the Lord.